You know, today I was doing some reflection. I was thinking about the first time that I got money. The first time that I was in a situation where I had more money than I needed. Where I had more money than I could spend. And based upon the comments I get on this channel, I know that many, many people they've never been in that situation. And I want to talk about the journey of going from being beyond flat broke. I mean, I didn't have any money. I didn't have any assets. I had nothing. It was just me. My dreams, a lot of the things that I wanted to do, but I didn't understand how the world worked. I didn't understand how money worked. I didn't understand nothing. I was completely ignorant to the processes of getting money outside of a job. I was uneducated. Let's just say that I was completely uneducated and I didn't understand, and there was no YouTube, there was nobody like me putting out this kind of content. But I want to tell you how I felt when I was broke. Honestly, I felt less than a man. I had children that I could not provide for. I couldn't provide for myself. I was eking out this meager living, and I didn't really respect myself. I was went through various phases of depression, and I understood early on that the system wasn't out to help me. The system wasn't designed to, well, I should say the general system. There's the general system and there's the esoteric system, and I exist in the esoteric system right now. When you make more in a month than most people make in a year, you're in the esoteric system. And one of the things that I came to understand, put that back, we had slipped down a little bit. One of the things that I came to understand was I had to do something different. I had to create a different level of energy. I had to really perform at a different level. I had to really open myself up to elevate myself. And I didn't really know how to do it. Because, I mean, once I figured out how the system worked, once I began to figure out how things operated, I was well on my way. Like, let's take how I got the job at Rent-A-Crate. I got the job at Rent-A-Crate because I was very creative. I knew that they would check me out, but they wouldn't check out my reference. So that's how I got in at Rent-A-Crate. If you want to know the story, it was essentially I created a fake reference to give to anyone that would give me an opportunity for the job, and it worked. It worked really, really well. And I began to deploy that kind of thinking in other areas of my life, because one of the things that I began to understand was the world will meet you where you will, the world will meet you at a level that you arise. The world will greet you at a level that you ascend to. And I was doing a lot of low-level thinking, which was one of the reasons that I was in the position that I was in. because I wasn't thinking on a higher level. I did not have big goals. I did not have big dreams. I was thinking at a very, very low level. I was thinking on a level of survival. I was thinking about just surviving. That's where my thought process was. How do I make it to the next day? And this becomes a circular way of thinking. This becomes perpetual, that you, hold on. All right. It becomes perpetual that you stay in this circular level of thinking where surviving becomes a habit. And that's where I was. And then when I got laid off, that broke me out of that habit, and that broke me into a higher level of thinking. That opened the door to, all right, I gotta do something massive. I gotta do something big. I gotta do something different to get out of this situation. And that's one of the things I did. I came up with my plan, I executed, and it worked. And then I went through a whole metamorphosis that I was going to become trained. Any job I got was going to give me skill sets that I did not presently have. That was how I played the game, you know. And then I stayed at Rent-A-Crate for a few months. Then I moved to Panel Systems Unlimited, where I got a big raise, because I went from $38,000 a year to $62,000, huge, huge pay increase. And then I left Panel Systems. Then I went to Business Environments, where I essentially left $62,000 and started making six figures. And this is where the change happened, because, you know, I was happy to be doing what I was doing at Rent-A-Crate, because that opened up a door for me and that pulled me out of the bad financial situation that I was in. But I really didn't start feeling it. I didn't start feeling it until I got in Business Environments and I made that first move that got me that first big check. And I'm gonna tell you, the first time when you don't have anything and you don't really come from anything, the first time you get a big check, you go crazy. You have all of these pent up desires and wants and wishes, and it becomes overwhelming. So the first thing I did, went out and bought a brand new BMW, went to the dealership. I walked in there like I was the man. And I was like, hey, what do you got there? I like that 540. Yeah. How much is it? All right, I can do that. And they were like trying to take me to the finance guy. And I said, no, I'm paying cash. I was like so proud to say that. I mean, I was like performing a little bit. And then that first time I paid cash money for a brand new car, the feeling, the exhilaration, the awesomeness of doing that and knowing that when I drove that car off the lot, it was mine. Knowing that. And then that was the first level of significance, because it was like, okay, you can pay cash for cars. You can do that. And, you know, I had someone on Savage Finance saying it was unrealistic to expect someone making $35,000 a year to save $30,000. And I'm like, it is not unrealistic if they employ to do more principal, which we're about to get into. And then I remember I was calling on this client, JDA, and they said, bluntly, we like you, we like what you have to offer, but we have a problem. If you will sell our office furniture for us, we'll buy the new furniture from you. So I took it back to the owner of Business Environments. He didn't want to do it. And I was like, you know, we don't do that. Just pass it up. And I'm like, you don't do that. So I came home and I created my first LLC. in my first company, which I tell you to do, start your company while you have a job. Don't quit your job to start a company. I mean, that's everyone's big wish, but realistically, you'll be better off starting your company while you have a job. So I did that, and that got me, I remember the first 2 months, I made $60,000 real quick, because I already had clients, you know, people that I had talked to that I could sell the furniture to. So I already had a pipeline, and it was nice. And then that third month, I did $100,000 in the money, and then I had deals that were coming in from business environments. So my checking account was looking like phone numbers, you know what I'm saying? You know, Wiz Khalifa. I was like, whoa, money was stacking up. And this is why I talk to you and tell you that you want to employ the do more principle, because this can put you in a situation where your money is coming in faster than you spend it. And that was the situation that I was in. I was making money faster than I can spend it. And it was amazing process. It was inspiring, because I would come home and I would go, because I was working like 60, 70 hours a week, and the money was coming in. And I remember the first time I looked in my checking account and saw I had over $200,000. I felt like a man, because I was able to provide for my kids, I was able to provide for myself, and I was able to live. I mean, you know, it was like I could spend money, and it didn't really matter, because as soon as I would spend it, it would be replaced with even more money. I was like, this is like crack. I like this. I'm having fun. I'm gonna keep doing it. And this is one of the things with the do more principle and understanding where you are in the world, because I was like, man, this is crazy. This is really, really crazy. And that feeling of pride, that feeling of accomplishment, that feeling of because I was like, no, I was transformed. The money transformed me. And this is one of the things, because I went through a transformative process, because I was able to make so much money so quick. And just literally a year and a half before that, I was living in a boarding house with crackheads. And this is the transformation, and this is one of the things I want to break down to you guys. When you start to employ the do more principle, you awaken a sleeping beast that is within you. Like, how many of you have ever saved money, and when you got to a big count, it became, you know, you're just like, you know, your goal was like to save $10,000, you got like $10,000-$12,000 in the bank, and then you wanted to start throwing more money at it because it became fun. It was like, oh, I like this. I like how this feels. I like how this tastes. And one of the things is, you know, it became addiction. It became an addiction, because I was like making money, selling furniture. I enjoyed that feeling. And it transformed me as a person, because it showed me what I could accomplish if I put my mind to it and if I worked really hard. And some of you are going to experience this, because some of you right now are catching hell. Bills are behind, you don't have no money, you're feeling bad, maybe you're a parent, you feel terrible because you can't do things for your children. And I'm here to tell you that you can transform, but you gotta follow the sequence. First of all, you gotta do more than you're already doing. That's the first thing. This is why I hate all of these advertisements like you can make $15,000-$20,000 per month working 4 hours per week. You can, but you gotta be in alignment with that thing. Because, I mean, honestly, when I focus on the things that make money, I can work literally an hour and make $25,000 by just sending out an email. But I had to build that up. I had to work on that. I had to do that. So, but the first thing is, you cannot do or make these fantastic sums of money just not doing what, you know, just doing what you're doing. You're gonna have to do more. You're gonna have to think bigger. You're gonna have to think broader. And like, the first time I got that money, I mean, I remember, because this was after I bought the car, because the car literally drained my checking account. I think I had $2,000 left after that. But the second go around is, this is the thing, I was spending money, but I wasn't spending money crazy. I didn't have a drug habit. I wasn't over there buying Gucci and $600 or $700. I wasn't doing any of that. But I was able to operate within my rim quite handedly because the money was coming in faster than I can spend it. And that is a position that I want you guys to be in. And you're gonna have to work. Like I said, I was working 70 hours a week. I was working. But work is fun when you're handsomely rewarded. Work is like a ball. Work is like joy. Work is like oxygen when you feel that your efforts are being properly remunerated. And I would work really hard and I'd make a lot of money. It was like, okay, you do this, pull this lever. Oh, money comes out. Okay, I'm gonna keep doing that. And this is why, you know, so many people are not successful because they're trying to cheat the system. They're not trying to work that hard. They're trying to rent seek because, like I said, if I understood the world back then the way that I understood the world now, I would have been a billionaire. Because one of the things is, you got to understand how the world operates. And it doesn't give a damn if you're black, white, green, Asian. It really doesn't care. If you're operating on a higher level in alignment with the wavelength of your talents. Because I was always a good speaker. And that made me a really good salesperson. Because I could talk someone into some buying some stuff. But one of the things is this transformational journey. And this is why Savage Finance is rooted in the Do More principle. Because, you know, if you're just trying to do your job, pay your bills, it's going to take forever. But if you do just a little bit more, just a little bit, it becomes transformative. It will change your life. It will create a different level of living, a different level of being, a different experience. It will completely transform you. It will completely rebuild you and rejuvenate you because, you know, I was having so much fun. It was like, yeah. Because, you know, and always in the back of my mind, it was like, man, a year and a half ago, you were living in a boarding house. You were living in a boarding house. So when I started to tap in to my inner power, when I started to tap into who I really was, my true self, my authentic self, and I started to make money, I started to enjoy life. I started to really begin to move the needle and begin to see what life was about. Because I think one of the worst things as a parent is when your child needs something, you have to say no. Not want, but need something. And that is just a very depressing feeling for a parent. But one of the things that I want you guys to understand is if you start to create businesses that are in alignment with who you are, that's where the money is. That's where the money is. I'm trying to tell you. Because I got some special stuff that's coming up. I'm not going to talk about it because it's not really done. Because the concept's not. But it's going to be something like your financial toolbox. Something that I'm going to create for Savage Finance. I'm working on that. So one of the things I want you guys to understand is, regardless of your present circumstances, you can do better in the future. And that was something that used to have me down, because I was in a really bad spot. I was depressed. I was not really well. I wasn't well because, you know, I wasn't making any money. I was having all these issues. But once I went through that situation and I began to live life and begin to bank differently, because when you got 200K in the bank, oh, everybody in the branch know who, they know your name. They know who you are. Just 200K. I've experienced that. And the level of respect that you get when you are living like that, when you are on that level, that people will respect you, people will treat you better because you got a little money. And I know that people are like, well, everyone should be treated special. And the world don't work like that. I'll do a whole video on that, because some of the things that have happened to me because my bank account had what was looking like phone numbers, it's just the reality of people. Because my current bank, there's a little girl in there, and you know, I swear she'd be flirting, but she said she married, but I swear she'd be flirting hard, and it's kind of funny. But that's all I wanted to bring to you guys right now. So go below, get the 30 days to 2500. Go below, get the hustler's mindset, pimping your mind for success. Go ahead and grab that. Go ahead and get that. And so you can start your transformative journey, and you can begin starting to build yourself a better life. That's what I want for you guys. I want you guys to have a better life. I want you guys to be living your best life, to be having fun, to have money, to do what you want, to enjoy yourself, to do that. So that's all I got for you guys. I'll see you guys in the next video.